Hello, everyone. I just got home from seeing the latest star-stacked film, Dune, a movie about, a bunch of people are named the new rulers of a desert planet that is also the home to a very magical and powerful spice, also worms. And I thought it was great. I enjoyed just about everything in this movie. So let me get the bad things out of the way first. The movie is super long. It's 2.5 hours, and I was fine for a majority of it, but it was probably the last half hour I really felt it start to slog. Another thing was I had a hard time understanding a lot of the dialogue. Maybe it's just my rampaging tinnitus, but many of the characters mumbled their lines. Finally, I don't know if it was just the theater I was in, but the lighting was way too damn dark. This is the second time this has happened in like 2 weeks. This was an issue I had with No Time to Die. A lot of the interior and nighttime scenes were so dark, I had a hard time seeing what was happening. What's the deal, guys? It can't hurt to brighten it up a little, but those were the only issues I had, and I think they're pretty minor. None of them really took me out of the movie. Now, I listened to Dune on Audible. Fuck if I know what the story is. I was able to understand the book for about the first third, but after that, I had no idea. But what I was able to understand and remember translated to the screen quite well. A majority of what happened included parts I understood from the book, so I was able to follow along much easier. Like I already said, the cast is absolutely stacked, and they're all perfect for their roles. I can't even list them. It's so many familiar names and faces, and they're all really good. I liked the sound design and the score and how it only played at certain moments. The CGI was fine. There were a few moments it didn't look so good, but I mean, whatever. The cinematography was obviously fantastic. Aside from the lighting issue, there were many incredibly beautiful shots. The fighting choreography and editing were smooth and easy to follow. The writing was really good, although there was one part near the end I feel like they didn't need to include and could have just put it in part two. The scope of the movie is massive, and they really took their time to squeeze in just about everything from the book. So of course, this is at least a two-parter, and I think that's fine. That way they can take their time with it. Overall, I really liked the movie despite the few things I mentioned. I'll definitely be watching this again on HBO Max. And so therefore, I am giving Dune an 8 out of 10. Jason Momoa with no beard.